Welcome to this Hawaii video in which I will show you how to configure the Outlook add-in in Dynamics NAV. So in this video, you will see the required steps to configure and enable the Outlook add-in. We'll go there through these steps. First, I will discuss the prerequisites, what you need to be able to get started. Then we'll go through the setup or the assisted setup in the application. And last but not least, I will demonstrate how you can then activate the add-in and use it in the application. First, let's get started and have a look at the prerequisites. So our service tier should be configured to run with NAV user password authentication, ACS, Access Control Service authentication, or Azure Active Directory. You need that to be able to get started. Then in order to be able to use Outlook, these are the supported Outlook applications, so version 2013 or later, you can use the web application, you can use it of course for your iPad, your iPhone and your Android device. To be able to make the connection to an Exchange server, and you can connect to Exchange online if you would like to do that. And to run the Outlook application, multiple browser versions are supported, as you can see here below in the list. Additional software you might require, of course, is Office 2016, Office 2013 Service Pack 1 or later, or Microsoft Office 2010. So in the next step, we'll have a look at how we can get it set up. The first thing that you will do is you will go into the application to the assisted setup page and select Setup Outlook for Financials. When you click the link, a wizard starts that welcomes you to the Office add-in setup. And when you select the next button, and you then can select, for example, if you would like to set up the add-in for your organization or only for your own mailbox. Next, you can confirm if your email is hosted in Office 365, yes or no. And then in the next screen, you enter your email address and your password. Once you have done that, you click on the next button and the wizard is able now to start the configuration, which it will do if you select the Finish button. You will notice that a deployment will start, and at the end, the application is configured, email has been set up with your email address. Now let's have a look at how that works in the application. So once we are in the application, I will go to the assisted setup page. You can do that by looking for the page. And then here in this page, I select Setup Outlook for Financials, the wizard starts. I select the next button. I can do it for my mailbox or for my organization. And then I click on the next button. I enter my email address. And then of course, I also need to enter my password. And next I will be authenticated on the server. You will notice here, and the application is doing it. Connection has been made. And now I select the Finish button. And then the wizard can make the connection, in my case, to Office 365. Set up everything, and after that has been done, you notice here that this wizard is now completed. So now that we have configured our Outlook add-in, let's have a look at how we can get it up and running in the application. So here we are in the application. I launched my Outlook web application, and what I do right now, once I am in Outlook, is I go to my settings, and in settings I look for Manage Integrations. A window will open, and here you can see which add-ins are enabled, and you should see our Dynamics add-ins, for example, Document Links and Dynamics NAV. If they're not enabled in here, you can very simply enable or disable them. Once you've done that, you can close this window, and then, for example, you can create a new email and test the integration. So let me open that in a separate window. And maximize that. So where is this window? No, it opened here behind. I will maximize that. You should notice here the add-in buttons appearing. So for example, if I would send an email here, so let's select Peter Sedo from my Office 365. And then I can click on this button and I can have a look, for example, at Contact Insights. So a connection is being made in here. I can select a contact. I can see the information coming in from the application. So it is displayed here in this plugin. What can I also do? For example, I could have a look here and create a new purchase order, a new sales quote, for example, for my my contacts. And I notice here that the setup has been completed. Now, I will not demonstrate this in detail. I just wanted to demonstrate that you can set up these plugins to work, and these are a number of ways on how you can test these add-ins. So let's summarize our steps again. In the first step, I explained the prerequisites, what do you need to get started. Then I demonstrated how you can use the assisted setup to set up the Outlook add-in. And in step three, I demonstrated how you can use it, how you can test these add-ins in Outlook. So in this video, we covered the following topics: the Outlook add-in, the requirements, and the assisted setup to be able to get started. To learn more, please visit the following resources. Thank you for following this short video to explain how to configure the Outlook add-in in Dynamics NAV. This video in the How Do I series for Dynamics NAV is brought to you by Microsoft and Platan. See you in another one.